What's going on, Bella Gang? It's your girl, Levy Natural. I am back with a brand new Juicy Girl Talk video, Bella Gang Best Friends. In this Juicy Girl Talk video, I'm gonna be telling you ladies how to get him off your mind. If you clicked on this video, you're probably watching this because you recently just got into a breakup with your man, and for some reason, like, everything just reminds you of him. You can't get him off your mind. You want him back, but you know he's not good for you. It's toxic. Well, sis, sit back, relax. It's about to be another Juicy Girl Talk. I have 5 tips that will help you get him off your mind for good. If you're new to my channel, welcome to the Bella Gang. Bella Gang or no gang, I love you ladies so much. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Also, follow your girl on Instagram at Bella_bars. Love you. Okay, best friends, let's get started with tip number one, how to get him off your mind. Number one, very important, stay away from things that bring up old memories. So maybe, you know, you guys both had a favorite movie you guys used to watch, right? When y'all used to have your little Netflix and chill nights, or maybe there's a certain restaurant that you guys used to love going on Thursdays. Sis, stop going on Thursdays. You're gonna miss him, all right? And don't you dare, you know, go on a date with another man in that restaurant, because the whole time you're gonna be thinking like, oh my God, I remember when me and Derek used to sit over there by that little booth, by the window, like, I can't believe we're not together no more. Next you know it, the whole date, you are talking about your ex to your new potential bae. Okay, and then wonder why he don't call your ass back. Sis, you can never get a guy off your mind if you keep replaying. Oh yeah, I didn't even write that down. I'm gonna put that one number one. Stop replaying old memories of you guys together in your mind, okay? And that goes hand in hand with number one, because if you're watching a movie that you and your man, your ex used to watch, you're gonna start, it's gonna bring up memories. You guys are gonna be thinking about how cute y'all was. Then you're gonna start crying, getting depressed, calling your mom, calling your friends, and they're about damn tired of your ass when you keep talking about the same guy. And the reason why you're talking about him is because you're purposely going to that restaurant, watching that movie, you know what I'm saying? Or you probably have old pictures of y'all, you know, that you keep looking at, that is bringing up old memories, and we're only human. Especially women, like, we're so emotional, and when we love hard. So we really take breakups really harsh. So I'm not judging you, because I used to do this all the time. You know, but it's very important that if you want to get him off your mind for good, that you just stop watching anything or going places that reminds you of Derek, because you're going to think about Derek, okay? Let's move on to tip number two, how to get him off your mind. Number two is, if I'm looking down, I wrote it down on paper and I don't want to have the paper in my hand. Number two is, avoid contact with him. So maybe you guys run around the same group of friends, okay, mutual friends, and your friend is throwing a house party, and you know Derek is gonna be there. What do? A, do you go to the party? 2, do you stay home to avoid him? 3, you just go to the party. Let me just say that just avoid it. Especially if you guys break up is very freshly new, you're gonna have a lot of pent up emotions. And I tell you 2 reasons why you shouldn't go around him, especially when you guys first break up, because you're really sensitive, okay, right now. Imagine you go to the party thinking like, yeah, I'm about to slay. He about to wish that he never broke up with me. I look beautiful, da da da. Guess what? You go to the party and he got a new girlfriend. Yeah, he got a badass chick on his arm. And look at you, mouth open, looking dumb. Well, you should have just stayed home and avoided him. Because if he knows, if he's around the same group of friends, he's gonna know that they invited you too. So when you don't go, you're just making a statement. He's not gonna say nothing to you, but in his mind, he'll be like, damn, she didn't come. She probably didn't come for me. That's crazy, because like, that's unlike her. I know, because she missed me. I know she want me back. She would have came. So you not going is actually psychologically going to make him miss you. You know what I'm saying? And next you know what, he calls you. That's a good way. That's a good excuse for him to call you. Like, hey, like, I know he's going to come to the party tonight. Like, what's up? And you could be like, listen, we're not together. Like, I'm not ready to see you right now. Then who knows? Maybe you guys can reconcile and get back together. But if you're trying to get him off your mind, 9 times out of 10, you're trying to get him off your mind because he's toxic. And I'm not trying to promote toxic relationships up in here. Okay. So yes, avoid him avoid contact with him, and make sure that your friends understand this. Like, Do not invite me if you're inviting Derek. Respect me. Respect my relationship. Because some friends are messy. They won't tell you that. They'll be like, oh, yeah, he's not coming. And then when he comes, well, I mean, I didn't know he was going to be here, sis. Whole time they knew that he was going to be there. You know what I'm saying? That's why you got to make sure that your group of friends is really for you and not against you. Because fake-ass bitches, they love doing that, okay? But it's very important that you cut all contact from him, okay? Number three, don't give in. No matter what you do, no matter how hot and bothered you are, and you want that D, you want that eggplant, do not give in. You see this phone? It's a blessing and it's a curse. It's a blessing because if he calls you, it's like, oh, he's thinking about me. But it's a curse because you know he's not good for you. And he's probably calling you, you know, because he, you know, he wants to get closure, aka he wants to come and hit that one more time. All right? Say no. You need to change his name in his phone to do not pick up, to the devil's a liar. Whatever you gotta do to remind you, you're not picking up for a reason. If you leave his name the way it is, you know, sometimes you don't forget what somebody do to you, but you know, you miss him. So sometimes when you miss somebody, it overrides the effed up stuff that they did to you, which is not okay. Stop thinking with your heart and think logically. You know that you want to get him off your mind because he did you dirty. The same guy that did you dirty before, he's going to do you dirty again. It's a very small chance that a guy is really going to change. Usually, if you met them as an F-boy, they're going to continue as an F-boy. You met them as a player, he's going to continue to be a player. Stop thinking that you can change these men because you can't. The only person in this world that can change a man is God and the man himself if he wants to change for you. Okay, if he wants to be with you, he's scared to lose you, he gonna change. But if you done broke up 3, 4, 5 times, honey, and the fourth other woman came to you as a woman about him, then, you know, that's why you should not be picking up the phone. I have exes to this day that call me, and I be so tempted to pick up because it's like, he called me, I miss him, like, you know, I miss that eggplant a little bit. But then I'm like, nah, you ain't coming over here, you ain't coming to this place that I got all saged out and good vibes. You see my Buddha? I got a Buddha for good vibes, okay? No devil vibes allowed, period. No negative vibes. I don't care how good he looks, I don't care how much you miss a guy. You know, every time I let an ex back in my life, they show me why I don't F with them again. They show me why, you know? And, you know, let me just say that it's just not going to work out. If you pick up the phone, go ahead. Don't listen to me. Don't listen to your big sister. Pick up the phone. See what happens. You guys going to have a good time. Then he's going to go ghost on you. I promise you. He's going to go ghost on you. You're going to find out later on, like 2-3 weeks later, that he has another girl in his life. You're going to get tight. It's going to be a whole different cycle. You cry. You get mad at him. Don't talk to him. Then he called you back. Then you back in his life. You know, you don't deserve that. Ladies, we don't deserve that. Wishy-washy mess. We deserve consistency all year round. Okay, period. Sheesh. Let's move on, shall we? Let's move on to tip number 4, how to get him off your mind. Number four is actually my last tip. Wow. Okay, so number 4 is entertainment. You're probably like, sis, what does entertainment got to do with getting him off my mind? It has a lot to do with getting him off your mind. You know why? Because if you're out doing something fun and entertained, number one, you're not going to be thinking about Derek. Number two, you know, you're finally getting outside, so no more depression. And number three, you know, you can have, it's like you have the potential on meeting, you know, a potential new bae. But how are you going to get off Derek if you in the house all day thinking and crying about him all goddamn day? You know what I'm saying? Because Derek is not in the house crying, thinking about you. He's in other girls' guts right now. Literally. While you're crying at 3 o'clock in the morning, he's hitting somebody from the back at 3 o'clock in the morning. Trust me. Okay? He's not thinking about you. Especially if he did you dirty. Guys like that, they don't care. They don't have no repercussions about. They just move on to the next. Right? So while if he's not suffering, why should you be suffering? How about you go out? Stop telling your friends, I'm not in the mood. Get yourself in the mood. You know why you're not in the mood? Because you turn off all the lights in your house. You haven't showered for days because you keep thinking about the same guy. and you're playing all these love songs, you know, he's not coming back. Sis, he's not coming back. So the best thing that you can do is move forward with your life. Anything that God removes or takes away, I promise you, he's going to upgrade you with something better. Every time I was with an ex that I thought I would never get over, I got over them. And then they try to get with me like 3-4 times, like years later. And it's the best feeling when, you know, a guy did you dirty and you can just miss their calls, or you see them in person, you keep it short, you look sexy as hell, and tell him, listen, I don't have anything against you, but I really don't feel like we should ever speak again. And you walk your sexy ass, you know, you know, out of his life. That's what you gotta do with these guys. You know, they're not gonna change. I'm sorry, I wish that I could tell you, you know, things will get better, but it's not. Especially if this is like the third or fourth breakup. Dumb breakup to makeup situations, they're not good for your mental health. It's not. It's not. I said this in my last video. You know why? Because when it's good, it's great. And when it's bad, it's really bad. It's gonna affect your personal life. It's gonna affect your work. If you're in school, it's gonna affect your schoolwork. It's not worth it. You know what I'm saying? You're beautiful. You're gorgeous. I don't care what no one says. I don't care if he tells you that I'm the only guy you're gonna be that's gonna ever love you. That's a lie. They say that as a source of control so you can be under them. You know what I'm saying? You know, just set your standards and don't settle for nobody. That's it. You know, and if you want to get him off your mind finally, I have to put God in my videos. You pray about it. There's so many times where I prayed to God, went on my knees and prayed because I knew I couldn't do it alone. I knew that I was very naive and stupid, and that's the side effects to being in love. Even though we know somebody's not right, we don't care. We want to be wrong with them. You know Mary J. Blige's song? Me and Mr. Wrong get along so good, but it hurts so bad. Mr. Wrong by Mary J. Blige. After this video, go listen to it. But it's so true. Like, that used to be the theme song to my last situation. Like, when I was head over heels in love with this dude, he was so bad for me in every way possible. You know, didn't even do nothing for me, but our connection, I don't know. Something about him just, it was like the devil, honey. Like, I just couldn't shake him off. And I had to pray to God to get him off. But it's like, even though he's wrong, I don't want to be right. You know what I'm saying? You ever been in love like that where you don't want to, like, you know he's not bad. You know he's bad for you. But you don't want to hear nobody. I got you. I know what you guys feeling because I've been there, done that. But it's just not a happy feeling when you love somebody so much and they don't love you the same. And you can tell when somebody don't love you the same. You know, you can tell. You can feel it. Stop ignoring the signs that God keeps showing you or he's going to hurt you in the long run. Okay, stop dating men for the potential and start dating guys who actually do what the hell they said they gonna do. Period. Anyways, that's the end of my video. Before I start getting in my feelings and talking about these no good dudes. Okay, I love you, Bella Gang. Until next time, Bella Gang or no gang. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I love you, ladies.